Farmer Jesse here. Real quick video. Going to talk today about garlic and how late can you plant it. So let's do it. First things first, if you're not subscribed to this channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button. And if you are subscribed, you're awesome. Here's the thing. You can plant garlic pretty much all the way up to the spring, to the early spring, late winter, let's call it, in most regions, with some caveats. First is what kind of garlic you're planting. Second is where you're planting it. And then third is, have you done any sort of vernalization? So if you're doing a hardneck garlics tend to be the ones with the scape, they put up the flower, they need a longer vernalization period, which is a cold period of 40 degrees or below for 40 days. That's what they need to differentiate, to turn into cloves. They need that period in order to become a bulb garlic. Otherwise, what you often run into is like whole clove garlic, where it's just one single clove. And you can't grow out your seed that way, and you can eat it, but it's not that exciting. I don't really even know if you can replant it. I guess that maybe somebody can answer that question in the comments. Then you also have what's called soft neck garlic. This is Allium sativum. This is the garlic that has the soft neck. It's pretty appropriately named. And you can braid it together. It's what you often find in the South, where it doesn't need quite the vernalization period that hard neck garlic needs. So a lot of times people grow it in the South. In fact, if you're planting your garlic late, soft neck might be a better option than a hard neck garlic. Soft neck, should also be noted, often has way more cloves. They're smaller. You can grow bigger soft neck cloves, but a lot of times you get, where in a hard neck you may get 5 to 8 cloves, in a soft neck you usually get like 8 to 20 or more, but they're smaller. Generally speaking, there are a lot of different varieties. So that's just what I would do, is if I'm planting it super late, like closer to the spring, I may go with a soft neck. If I'm planting it, if I have time in the fall, November, December, even all the way up to the solstice and my ground's not frozen, I would go with a hard neck. Soft necks, another advantage to those is that they do last longer. They are a better storage variety than a lot of hard necks, but we have hard necks that go all the way to March, so in our hard neck that we use it's called Music. It's a really good variety. And we've planted that for years and it'll go all the way up into March without disintegrating, I guess. If you need to artificially vernalize, if you need to artificially give it that period of time, you need to do it in a dry space for 10 to 12 weeks beforehand. So what you would do is you take a bunch of garlic in the cloves, in the bulb still, so it'll actually hold on a little better. Take it in the bulb, put it into a paper bag or something that's dry. You don't want to put it in a plastic bag where it'll get fungal issues. You want to put it in something that's like paper or dry, and put it in a cooler or a refrigerator, not a freezer, a refrigerator, for 10 to 12 weeks. That's under 40 degrees for 10 to 12 weeks, and then plant it out as early as you can in the spring. Now, that's not a guarantee. Every variety is going to be a little different. If you have a really hot spring, that could affect the bulb creation, but that's your best bet if you're planting late, is to vernalize it yourself, especially with hard neck garlic. With soft neck garlic, you don't need the vernalization period quite as much. It may not hurt to put it in the fridge for a few weeks before you plant it, but you don't quite need the same vernalization period. The other thing you're gonna run into is the later you plant it, the smaller your bulbs are gonna be. So preferably you'd plant it absolutely as early as possible. If your ground is frozen right now, if you're in the north and you can't get your garlic in, you can do something like a deep compost. You'd have to put it pretty deep over top of your garlic to prevent it from freezing or getting too much winter damage. If you need to cool the ground artificially, like if your ground's kind of warm when you're putting it in the spring, like you're getting an early spring, put some mulch down, some light colored mulch, not like this is what we plant our garlic into. You don't want something dark that's gonna get warm. You'd want something that's gonna be cool, like straw or hay. That will help keep the soil cool so it won't develop too fast. If it develops too quickly, you're gonna get smaller bulbs, which is not as good for marketing. Other than that, any tips you all have for this, for planting late garlic, feel free to leave them in the comment section. I like this to be collaborative, you know my style. Otherwise, subscribe to this channel if you're not subscribed, hit the like button if you like this video, and we'll see y'all later. Thanks for watching, bye.